Okay friends, in this video we will sort the product according to category. For example, I will show you. I have some products: strawberry, cherry, orange, gulab jamun, chocolate, and I categorize into three categories: name, fruit, vegetable, sweet. Okay, if I slash here and put here vegetables, it must be sort by which product have this category ID. Okay, we will do it all dynamically according to our category ID, and we will make join two tables. So go to your favorite editor, open route web.php. after where you are displaying all data, here you will put new route, name it products slash, here is parameter call get, you can name it anything, and here you will put product. My model name is, wait a minute, my controller, actually products controller, products controller, here is product controller, add the date there, you will make new function procat. Okay, save it, go to your product controller, here you will create a public function, yes, procat, and it will be request your parameter, and let me show that parameter request, and parameter name is get. That's all. So let me check here, and here is your parameter. Nice. Save it as a variable, call it get. Now we need a query where we will return data according to our category joined with table name is products. We are choosing here join with table is cats, where cats dot id same equal to products dot cat id, and we need where condition. Their condition is cats dot cat name equal to this cat parameter and get function. Let me show you. Here is vegetables have a two products. Let me change the category sweets, and sweets also have a multiple products: strawberry, chocolate, gulab jamun, cherry, everything you can put here. And third one, fruit, and fruit have a three products: orange, grapes, pomelo, I think. Okay, if user click on only products, they can see all products. Now we need here make it view same like this view, but according to category, and we will show in our breadcrumbs here. If category have not any products, for example I put any randomly and zero, we will display error message, custom error message. Okay, so now open here, go to editor, we will save it to data, and here return view our is front dot products, as you already know, and here you will put here data, simply data variable, save it, go to here refresh, and you have an error. I forget to add semicolon, save it, reload, Now you have a three products by fruits category. Let me check sweet. Okay, it's sweets. Yes, so here is five products under sweets. Vegetable, here is fat. Now we need open our products view, front folder, products blade, inside our for each we will put here if data is empty. That means let me show you count. We will put here count to see what we are getting. You getting here 0, and here you getting here 2. We want to display that, so we will hit here if count equal to 0, and we will display our own message. Oh sorry, not curly brackets, only this. Else we will display for each with our dynamic data and end of and if statement. Okay, inside here we need to display you can say same view of, so we will copy this to div, close tag or div. Inside this we will put our own message, products. You can choose any name here. No products found under this category, and make it align center, save it, go to here. Okay, make it wrong spelling. You can see no product found here. I think it's not atom. Make it align center. I think I make it full width MD12. Save it. Okay, here is your data. Style margin. I'm not going too deeply in this design. That's all. Okay, no product found under this category, but we need to display category name here, which is coming from it. So for that, go to your route. Product controller, make here get by user, name it anything, just we need to pass this parameter. Okay, inside this you will find here just get by user and make it little bit bold, style color red, that will be fine I think, and close your BTAG, save it. Now you can see no product found under this category, and we need to display here also. Okay, here you will display just simply get by user, save it. Here is your breadcrumb. Now here also you need to define some parameter, if statement, if count data equal to 0, then you will display like this. But else, and if, and here just copy this, okay, and here you will put only B tag because we don't have this name of category, but here you have a category URL and your route name is products, and here your slash your get by user. That's all. Let me see what is going on. Okay, now it's only bold, not a anchor tag. But if put here actual category, now I must have a anchor tag. This is not displaying. Okay. Let me try vegetables. Oh, it's not anchor tag. Let me find out why. It's only bold. Okay, else if category data is empty, now it's all fine. Let me change this to check, get, save it. No, it's not changing. That means we have already this data, actual data. Now make it wrong. You have a wrong data, but not saying if count. Oh, sorry, is count here, not here. Save it, reload. Now you can see. Let me try with actual, and you have a get. Now let me make it get by user. Check your anchor tag is product fruit, so that means it's same page. So that's nice. It's your breadcrumb. Okay, now you can see if I put here any randomly category name, it will give you no product found. Okay, you can hide this also. Let hide this with this is the row, and this here is, you will put only if not zero, then it will show. And if save it, reload. Now you need second one also, so just put here, reload. Okay, if you need to reload with fruit, you can see all this, and wrong category, not found category, you can not can see this, and you can hide this also. And inside here you will put category by user. That's it. Let me show you here fruit, and you can see fruit here. Okay, next time we will categorize this by brand, price, sort, so, and much more. We will do it our account search also. We will do it all in the next upcoming videos. Thank you guys.